I've done two videos on Mboma with a focus on her testosterone levels. Some comments from the video suggest that I deliberately did not touch on her chromosome karyotype status, thereby making me disingenuous. The reason why I did not touch on it is that the World Athletics limited Mboma and Beatrice Masilingi based on testosterone levels. That is why I tackled it from that angle. The Namibian authorities said a test run on Mboma and Beatrice Masilingi revealed that they have 46 XX chromosome karyotype, making them women. The World Athletics regulations on testosterone harvest on athletes with a 46 SYDHD. So it is not that clear. But what if Christinemboma has 46 SYDHD? Does that make her a man? Let us have a brief take on the chromosome karyotype issue now. Note before, we are operating on the assumption that she has a 46 SYDHD. The 46 represents the total number of chromosome cells in the body. A person with a 46 XY is rendered a man, and a person with a 46 XX is rendered a woman based on the chromosome karyotype analysis. But hold on. That is why in some special cases, you also have what is termed DSD. It means a disorder of sexual development in the womb, which is called androgen insensitivity syndrome. It means that just like some people can be born with a disorder but are still humans, there are some women and men born with this chromosome disorder, but that does not change their gender. According to Dr. Chamien Quinley, a pediatric and endocrinologist, there are about 7,500 women in the United States with this condition. And for your information, there are men with 46 XXDSD. This means that they have no Y chromosome, which is associated with being a man. But these people are real men. They only have a disorder. According to estimates, about 1 in 20,000 men in the United States of America do not have a Y chromosome. In fact, many people don't even know they have a disorder. There are women with internal testes, but they do not know.
Like, seriously?
What this means is that some people who are bashing Christinemboma and her colleagues may themselves be in the same situation. Mboma and Beatrice's family and coach did not even know of this condition. Even the girls were in shock of the results. That is why it is now a myth in the science world to only assign sex development purely based on chromosomes karyotype. Science now considers other factors also, because in reality, there are about 30 genes that have been found to play a role in sex determination. Three of these genes are located on the X chromosomes, and one is located on the Y chromosomes. The rest are located on other chromosomes known as autosomes. Sex determination is no longer determined by only X and Y chromosomes. Some researchers say that sex should be determined not only by chromosomes, but also by the total genetic makeup of the person and the functions of these genes during development, as well as the distinctive reproductive system in males and females. The newsflash is that abnormalities occur. The woman you are married to may have 46 XYDSD, and the man you are married to may have 46 XXDSD. When you run a test and it is so, are you going to refer to your wife as a man and your husband as a woman? That is why World Athletics has never called DSD athletes men. They call them women, but with high testosterone levels. That is why I've always limited my previous videos on testosterone levels. In reality, is Mboma running like a man? Is Beatrice Masilingi running like a man? Let us face it. Their times are not even close to the men who run similar events at the high level. Thank you very much, and remember to like, subscribe, and comment.